Use the graph below to answer the following questions about f of x. C, over which interval or intervals is f of x increasing? D, over which interval or intervals is f of x decreasing? Well, the first thing we want to recall is that when we're working with function notation, we have y is equal to f of x. So when we see f of x, we can be thinking about the y values. So instead of reading for C, over which intervals is f of x increasing, we could be reading it over which intervals are the y values increasing. And for part D, we could be thinking over what intervals are the y values decreasing. Well, the y values will increase if the graph is rising from left to right. The y values will be decreasing if the graph is falling from left to right. So let's go ahead and answer part C. Over which intervals is f of x increasing? Well, as we start from left to right, we see that the graph rises starting at negative 6. Notice that we have negative 8 marked along the x-axis, and there are 1, 2, 3, 4 tick marks. 8 divided by 4 is 2, so we know that the scale is 2. So the graph starts to rise at negative 6, and it stops rising once we get to 2. So we're going to indicate that along the x-axis, that the graph started to rise at negative 6, and it stopped rising at 2. And then we'll shade everything in between because the graph is rising between negative 6 and 2. In other words, if we pick any two points in this interval, the point on the right is going to be higher than the point on the left. Is there any other place where the graph is rising? Well, as we move along the function, we see that it starts to rise again, starting at 8 and ending at 12. So it rises from 8 until we get to 12. So we'll go ahead and put a bracket, 8, and then end bracket at 12. And we'll shade everything in between because that's where the graph is rising. So over what interval is f of x increasing? It's increasing on the interval from negative 6 to 2. And also on the interval from 8 to 12. For part D, over which interval is f of x decreasing? Well, decreasing means that the graph is going to be falling from left to right. We see that there's only one interval where that's true. The graph is falling from 2 to 8. So we put a bracket at 2, a bracket at 8, and shade in everything in between. Now in this case, the reason we include the bracket is because if we pick any two points between negative 2 and 8, the point on the right is going to be lower than the point on the left. So for part D, we only have one interval where the function is decreasing. That is the interval from 2 to 8.